The scripture reading for this morning has already been delivered in the King James Version of Scripture. I will read it once more for your hearing from the New International Version of Scripture. I want to talk on this morning about having limited vision. Having limited vision. Will you hear these words from the New International Version of Scripture? Mark chapter 6, verses 1 to 6. Jesus left there and went to his hometown accompanied by his disciples. When the Sabbath came, he began to teach in the synagogue, and many who heard him were amazed. "Where did this man get these things?" they asked. "Was this wisdom that has been given him? What are these remarkable miracles he is performing? Isn't this the carpenter? Isn't this Mary's son and the brother of James and Joseph, Judas and Simon? Aren't his sisters here with us?" And they took offense at him. Jesus said unto them, "A prophet is not without honor except in his own town, among his relatives, and in his own home." He could not do any miracles there except lay his hands on a few sick people and heal them. He was amazed at their lack of faith. Then Jesus went around teaching from village to village. My brothers and sisters, in this portion of scripture, we find Jesus rejected at Nazareth. Again, I want to talk about having limited vision. Jesus is rejected at Nazareth. Home is where Jesus is rejected. Now, I think many of us believe that home is supposed to be welcoming, right? I mean, it's so welcoming that we have created heartfelt sayings attached to home. I'm pretty sure you've heard some of these sayings. There's no place like home. Home is where the heart is. Even as we've been in this pandemic called COVID-19, coronavirus, we've even come up with another heartfelt saying about home. We said, "Safe at home," but Jesus is rejected at home. Now, Jesus, he grew up in Nazareth, but he lived somewhere else. He moved to Capernaum near the southwest side of the Sea of Galilee. Jesus moved there to fulfill a prophecy. You see, in Matthew chapter 4, verses 12 to 17, we find that when Jesus got word that John had been arrested, he returned to Galilee. He moved from his hometown Nazareth to the lakeside village of Capernaum, which is nestled at the base of the Zebulun and Naphtali hills. This move, it was Isaiah's revelation. You see, if you were to turn to Isaiah chapter 9, you would find Isaiah saying, "Land of Zebulun, land of Naphtali, road to the sea over Jordan, Galilee, crossroads of the nations." People sitting out their lives in the dark saw a huge light sitting in that dark, dark country of death. They watched the sun come up. Yes, this was Isaiah's prophesied revelation. It came to life in Galilee the moment Jesus started to preach. But still, Jesus is rejected at Nazareth. Has anyone ever been rejected? You may be a child, but you have faced rejection. You know, we can have money, but we can still face rejection. We can be educated, but still face rejection. We can be kind to people, but still face rejection. Oh, Mark's gospel here, he shows a sharp contrast between what we would consider success and failure. Contrast between acceptance and opposition. We see a contrast between understanding and misunderstanding. Many of us have faced those contrasts ourselves, we see that these people, they have limited vision. They're guilty of a misguided evaluation, if you will. We can see clearly in the text that they are evaluating Jesus, right? Yes, they had already decided what they thought about Jesus. They had already decided not to believe in Jesus. We see that they, think about the Messiah, after all, as this person who would come in a unique way. This Jesus, this doesn't seem very unique. We find that they evaluate Jesus. Isn't the Messiah supposed to be different than all other people? I mean, the Messiah already. I mean, consider the questions that they asked. They evaluate and they say, isn't this the carpenter? You know, we already know this guy, right? He's a carpenter. Don't we already know him? One carpenter, you've seen one carpenter, you've seen another. Isn't this Mary's son? You know Mary, don't you? I know Mary. We know meeting Jesus. Aren't his sisters with us? There's an old saying, contempt. You know, older adults are especially guilty of this saying. They're guilty of looking down upon a person simply because that person grew up in their midst. And I wonder if we in 2021 can become so familiar with God that it limits our vision. We're looking at these people and their evaluation of Jesus, but what is our view of God in 2021? Maybe there are moments when we say, God can do it, but let me evaluate. I wonder if there are moments when we say, God says this, but let me evaluate. Are there moments when we think that God can use a person, but let me evaluate? But I want to remind us in 2021 and forever that God does not need our help. God does not need a checkpoint from humanity. God does not need our evaluations to guide life's situations. God is able. These people had limited vision connected to a misguided evaluation. Their limited vision was not only because of misguided evaluation, but these people also missed an opportunity. You see, because of their limited vision, they did not get all that they could from Jesus. They lacked faith, so they missed an opportunity. And throughout Scripture, Jesus showed his power in the presence of faith. When people have faith, Jesus showed great power. Jesus had already performed great miracles before he even arrived at Nazareth. Oh yes, Jesus had already done powerful things in the midst of faith. In Mark's gospel, when we read Mark's gospel, we find that Jesus had already done amazing things, like he drove out an impure spirit. Oh, yes, look at your Bible. Look at Mark. Even before chapter 6, Jesus had healed Simon's mother-in-law. Jesus had healed many with various diseases, those who were sick and demon-possessed. He even healed a man with leprosy. And Jesus did not stop there. Jesus was busy and amazing when he healed a man with a shriveled hand. Yes, Jesus had been busy before he got home. There was a dead girl, Jairus' daughter, that Jesus raised from the dead, and there was a woman with an issue who touched the hem of Jesus' garment, and she was made whole. Now here he was. The Bible says, when the Sabbath came, teaching in the synagogue, and many who heard him were amazed, but you know what? They were not impressed. Isn't that interesting? Amazed by God, but not impressed by God. They missed it. And I can't help but wonder if we are missing it even now. I wonder if we're missing it because of our limited vision and view of God. Are we missing it? Are we looking at God and we are amazed, but not impressed? I wonder if we're like that guy where he was caught in a, there was a flood about to happen. And so because the water was rising, he went and he prayed to the amazing God. He said, Lord, you know that the water is beginning to rise. God, you're amazing. Would you please rescue me? And so as time went on, a rescue squad came by. And the young man said, you all go ahead. I'm waiting for the amazing God to save me. So he stayed there in the water. It rose a bit higher, and he had to get on his roof, the roof of his house. And so then a boat came by, and he said, no, you can go ahead because I'm waiting for the amazing God to save me. All of a sudden, the water got so high to where, although he was on his rooftop, the water was rising to his waist, and a helicopter came by. And the man said, no, you all go on. I'm waiting for the amazing God to save me. And so he waited, and you know what happened? That young man drowned. He died, and when he got to heaven, he said, God, I prayed, and you're so amazing. Why didn't you do something? He said, you're amazing. God said to the young man, you believe that I was amazing, but you weren't impressed because I sent a rescue squad by, and I sent a boat by, and I sent a helicopter by. But because you were not impressed with the way that I choose to bless you, here you are now. So all I'm trying to say, my brothers and sisters, is ask yourself, is God impressive? Ask yourself, is God amazing? Ask yourself if God still performs miracles. I want you to know that the answer to all of those questions is yes. God is still able to heal from cancer. God is still able to give you a job. God is still able to show you that what you're worth. God is still able. God is not only amazing, but God is impressive. Oh, yes, I know that someone knows exactly what I am talking about. When was the last time you were impressed by God? Well, know that when we do have faith, Jesus turns away no one, but welcomes everyone. Even though Jesus was rejected in this text, we today still have total access to Jesus. You see, limited vision gives us limited access. But when we truly have faith in God and we believe, we have full access to what God can do. I tell you, you have to decide to follow Jesus. But not just that. You have to decide to truly believe in Jesus. I tell you, when I was a girl, I would hear my grandmother, who truly believed in Jesus, talk about how important it was to follow Jesus. There's a song that goes like this. She would say, I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. The world behind me, the cross before me. The world behind me, the cross before me. The world behind me, the cross before me. No turning back, no turning back. Oh, glory, hallelujah, amen. Glory, hallelujah, amen.